All right, what's up everybody? I've got my new bag out here with me. Time for our first YouTube video of 2023. Didn't do a lot in 2022, so let's change that. If you don't know me, my name is Gilly. Welcome to the channel, and let's go ahead and get into it. We're playing Bradley Center today, and it's just gonna be kind of a very free flow form vlog. We're gonna try to change things up a little bit. Let's do this. All right, guys, so you will notice one thing different. I am wearing some Dark Ace apparel. I am sponsored by Dark Ace now, super excited about that. So stay tuned for more to come about that. And if you want to support me, you can always inbox me and ask me the best ways to do that. All right, hole number one, you kind of just want to put it out straight through the gap. We're gonna go with our pyro so that it'll go out and then fade left where we want it to. All right, guys, so we birdied hole number one and we actually just had a surprise disc return. Somebody just returned to me a buzz that I died a long time ago. It's the 2021 Halloween buzz with the Cenobite. I can't remember his name off the top of my head, but it's the one from the movie Hellraiser. Henhead, that's his name. Let's go ahead and throw hole number two. You can probably tell it's gonna be a forehand shot for me. It curves that way. So I'm gonna go with my orbit felon. Let's do it. Somebody's getting in trouble over there.
So if that didn't get kicked down, we would have been real close to the basket.
All right, y'all, hole three. I'm throwing my pyro. All right, guys, so we're kind of stuck in jail with these trees. The path is actually right there. That's where the opening is, but we're facing much more this way. So we've got a tiny hole right here where my finger's pointing that we can use to get through there. So that's what we're gonna try to do. Let's hope for the best. Alrighty, guys, we are now two down through three, which I love to hear. Starting pretty strong. Let's see if we can keep it going. There's a guy behind us, so I might just do a check-in on each tee pad, maybe, just to get a few holes in front of him. We'll see. I don't like people encroaching on me when I'm filming. Oh, he almost just made a big putt. Oh, he almost just made another big putt. Gastonia disc golf is so good and people don't even know about it, y'all. Hole number five. You can see where homie's finishing up down there. And we are throwing Swirly Shirley with the whale pants stamp on it. Swirly Shirley. Alrighty, y'all, we're fairly short from this position here from the basket. It's still a straight tunnel down that. Ooh, camera work is hard that way. So I'm gonna introduce you guys to a new disc that I've been throwing for a while, but you guys haven't seen me throw a lot of. The Castoplast Berg. Since I'm not really throwing wild discs anymore, not doing anything with them, I'm trying to get wildly way out there and try a whole bunch of crazy stuff. And I'm loving the Berg in the K1 plastic. I used to have one in K3 plastic, but those just flip pretty easily. So get yourself a K1 Berg, they're pretty awesome. There's the Berg, there's the basket, there's the par. All right, guys, we are now two down through five. I'd like to be a little bit more than that, but we're still under par. Hole six is pretty much just a hyzer tunnel shot, kind of. It goes straight with the tunnel and it turns to the left. And that's kind of also a tunnel. So you just kind of get left. Sort of. I'm making it sound like it's a hard shot. It's just a hard shot. We're throwing uphill, and the more you go left, there's a cliff right where the basket is. So you just have to be careful. It's a hard, careful hike. We're going to be throwing a Kevin Jones distortion. I'm really, really liking this look. It's a little bit thinner than a zone. So for you backhand approach throwers, he's going to like this. Alrighty guys, we did get the birdie there, so we are now 3 down through 6, pretty happy with that. On to hole number 7, and hole number 7 is kind of interesting. We're throwing uphill this time. The road is OB, and you can kind of see the baskets up here on this hill somewhere. I'm not sure if you can see it through the camera anywhere or not. But that's hole 7. It is 231 distance, and it says it's 20 feet up in elevation. So I like to do the crazy thing. I like to try to skip it off the road with an overstable driver and make it bounce towards the basket. So, yeehaw, let's do it. I'm gonna go with a Ricky Wysocki orbit cone. Alrighty guys, we are 3 down through 7 now. Not too bad, not shabby at all. We are on to hole number 8. It's 312 feet with 20 feet down in elevation. This is what we're looking at. There is a mando up there. You gotta throw through that and you wanna kinda trail down to the right. That's what I apologize for. You wanna trail down to the right after you hit the mando. So let's see if we can get it. All right, so I just want to tell you guys that that little Anheuser throw that I just did right there with that MD2, wow, that's a shot that I have been really struggling with learning. So that kind of felt like a growth moment. And I hope that if not anything else this year, you guys will see that I have grown a lot. And you guys will see that we are going to be doing some big things in disc golf. So now's the time to get tuned in to Gilly's Disc Golf. If you want to be considered an OG, from this moment on, you're all OGs. Here's to a good year, y'all. Let's keep playing good. We're almost to the end of the round. Alrighty guys, we are 3 down through 8. We saved the par on number 8, so pretty happy about that. Can't complain. That's actually definitely one of the best shots I've ever thrown on 8. So, growth moment, and it happened for YouTube. Happy about that. All right, welcome to hole number 9. This is one of my dream aces. I mean, look at this thing. It is sitting there waiting for someone to just smash the ace on it. And I've almost done it. I've hit the cage, I've hit the band. I've even rolled up on the hill right here and rolled all the way down and sat next to the basket. Not supported by the basket, just sitting next to it, touching it. So the ace is definitely gonna happen. I'm tired of not getting it, so we're gonna smash it sooner or later, and we're gonna give it 2 tries for the camera today. We're gonna go with PD on both shots. Discmania PD. That was too low and too flat. You see what I'm saying? Alrighty guys, so I've tapped in for my three. And we finished 3 down through 9. Thanks for hanging out for this front nine of Bradley Center. I will come back very soon and shoot a back nine for Bradley Center. And then what we'll do is we'll move to another course in Gastonia. And then we'll move to another course in Gastonia. And then we'll move to a course in Charlotte. And then another one. And the next day. And the next day. And we're just gonna have a great time with it, guys. So I'm really excited to bring you much more content on YouTube this year. And we're gonna play some fun games. We're gonna have some fun visitors. It's gonna be awesome. So cheers to the future. Play disc golf, listen to metal, chase aces. And here's a little sneak at something new I got coming. The clue is reap your birdies. See if anyone can guess what it is. Y'all have a good one.